Firefox is a very powerful browser that lets you be in control of your browsing experience entirely. With the right tweaks, not only can you significantly boost your privacy and security unparalleled to any other browser out there, you'll also double your rendering speeds and lower your bandwidth and memory usage. Getting maximum privacy and security will require to go through a plethora of settings Firefox allows you to change, as well as installing a selection of privacy-enhancing extensions that will protect your privacy even more. Going through all these steps is absolutely worth it, because your browsing habits reveal a lot about your personal life. Unfortunately, default Firefox settings don't really protect your privacy that much, so let's change that. Right off the bat, go to Content Blocking and select Strict Blocking. Don't worry, this is nowhere near so strict and will probably not break any website you visit. If it does, all you need to do is to easily disable blocking for the current website. You can see that upon visiting Reddit, Firefox is blocking Amazon ads and a Google tracking script. But there is so much more Firefox can do for us. Scroll down to History and choose Use Custom Settings for History. Choose Always Use Private Browsing Mode. This will restart your session, and from now on, Firefox will be erasing almost all browser data each time you close it. Is this necessary? Yes. Over time, browsers can pile up insane amount of information about your browsing habits, which is very revealing about your personality and can be used by advertisers and political campaigners to target you with ads. If you are changing these settings on a Firefox you've been using for a while, you can easily clear all previously stored data in privacy, cookies and site data, and under History, clear History. Select everything and set time range to everything. Under Address Bar, uncheck suggestions for browsing history, bookmarks, and open tabs. This means your browser will not show you any suggestions in the URL bar as you type. It prevents further collection of data potentially stored on your device. Under Permissions, go to Settings for Location, Camera, Microphone, and Notifications, and select Block New Requests asking to access each of these parameters. By default, Mozilla will collect some information from your Firefox. This is not good, but it's easy to turn it off with a single click. Blocking dangerous and deceptive content might be useful for secure browsing, but this service is provided by Google Safe Browsing, which you actually don't see here. So I choose to not trust Google with my security. Under Search Settings, I like to have a search bar that lets me more easily change my search engine when I need to. I always use more than one search engine, especially when I'm looking for news and political content. Change your default search engine to DuckDuckGo and opt out of search suggestions so that your search records aren't shared with the provider. I never use Google, Bing, Amazon, or Twitter to search for anything, so I always remove them. What I do use is StartPage. The easiest way to add new search engines is to just go to their website and Firefox should automatically suggest it for you to add it. Another private meta search engine is Circs. Circs.me instance is a pretty good start. I like to clear my homepage as well. I don't want Firefox to start with any website when I launch it, so I leave it at Firefox Home or set it to blank. Opting out of top sites and highlights can be a minor privacy benefit as well. If you are used to syncing, I would recommend against it. If you need to transfer your Firefox data, you can always just manually copy your Firefox profile folder and move it into another device root directory. This is so that you don't have to transmit your browser data and settings over the internet, or you can encrypt it yourself rather than trusting someone else. To find your Firefox profile folder, type About Profiles into your address bar and open folder from the root directory. This is what you want to copy if you want to transfer your settings and bookmarks the most secure way possible. Now, this should cover all the visible settings offered by Firefox, but there is so much more under the hood. To get under the hood, type About Config in a new tab, hit Enter and click I accept the risk. This will show you all available settings that you can hardcode into Firefox. Some of these you should change, and some of these you shouldn't touch at all. Luckily, Firefox allows us to search for settings we need to tweak. Privacy Tools has a compiled list of settings that will significantly improve your private browsing experience. They start with disabling WebRTC leaks, which is useful if you want to use a VPN more securely. You can either copy each individual setting and then make sure the value matches with the recommendation on the website. If it doesn't, then double-click on it to change it. Do the rest with all the other recommendations. All the remaining privacy tweaks are actually copied from the official Mozilla wiki page. If this sounds too daunting to you, there are utilities that claim to do something like this for you. But personally, I'm not sure if they make it any easier. There is even an add-in for this called Privacy Settings, which is pretty good, but I like to do it manually. You only have to do this once. If you want to copy your settings, all you have to do is to copy your Firefox profile into a new folder in the root directory. Now, all of this makes Firefox a pretty powerful privacy browser, but it can still use some help from extensions. One of the most important steps to take to browse more privately is to learn to block scripts. The quickest way to do this is to use NoScript Security Suite. uBlock Origin and uMetrix also let you block scripts. I have tutorials for all three, so the choice is yours. You can also combine NoScript to block scripts and uBlock Origin to block ads. It is also possible to use uBlock Origin to block scripts and ads with one add-in. The way I use it is that I go to uBlock Origin settings. I check I'm an advanced user, all privacy settings, and I disable media, remote fonts, and JavaScript. Then I go to filter lists and I check all uBlock Origin filters, malware domains, and HP host ad and tracking servers. Then I open uBlock Origin menu and I set it to block all third-party requests. It's really incredible how powerful uBlock Origin can be. With these simple tweaks, you can literally block all trackers, ads, and malware on the web. It will be impossible for most websites to track you, especially in combination with compartmentalization, which I explain in my latest privacy tutorial. I have explained how to use uBlock Origin in the past, so I won't go into detail here, but these are the settings I use for maximum privacy. There are other three add-ins that are very useful, and that's HTTPS Everywhere, which will force encryption on websites that enable it. If you want to be more secure, you can set it to block all unencrypted connections. Cookie Auto-Delete is fantastic at isolating and getting rid of cookies. And Decentralize is very helpful at preventing content delivery networks from Google and others to track your internet activity. Do you need any other extension for privacy and security? Probably not. Minimalism is a good approach when it comes to internet privacy and security. You don't want to clutter your browser with too many extensions, a combination of which can be used to identify you. The only browser that gives you more privacy is Tor Browser Bundle, which gives you an anonymous fingerprint and routes your traffic through Tor network. What's great is that all these settings and add-ins can also be enabled on Firefox Mobile. Using a combination of browsers like Firefox Focus, DuckDuckGo, Privacy Browser, and Web Apps will give you more granular control over compartmentalization of your internet presence. And that's it. You have now configured Firefox settings for maximum privacy and security. Congratulations.